Mrs. Johnson, I've got a lot to say today. Would you mind taking a few notations for me? Thank you. You're a sweetheart. I love it. What? You quit? Forget you then. I'll just get YouTube to do it for me. Annotate. Okay. Getting a little crowded in here. Just a little bit more than I thought it would be. Let's jump off into YouTube and I'll show you how to get it done. Here we are in YouTube. Before I get into getting our annotations knocked out, I want to tell you what annotations can do to help you and your YouTube channel. Annotations are used to increase engagement in your videos. You can use them to add text to explain something about the video, add text that ask your viewers to like, favorite, or share a video. You can ask a question to get people to leave comments on the video. You can add clickable subscribe buttons, thumbnails, and links to other videos that you have on your channel. You can link to other parts of the same video. You can link to a video playlist, a website, merchandise store, social media sites, all of that. Basically, what I'm saying is annotations are fantabulous, splendorific, and marveloso. They're going to do a lot to help you out. So let me get into this and show you how to get down with some annotations. First thing you want to do is click on the icon on the upper right side of your screen. When you click on that, you want to go to the Creator Studio. Once you're in the Creator Studio, you want to go to the left side of your screen and you want to click on Video Manager. Once you're here, you want to select the video that you want to add annotations to. And when you find that video, you click on the Edit button. Once you get to the edit screen, you go up to the annotations button and select that. The video will start playing when you get to this screen, so you want to click on the pause button to stop it from playing. And you want to use this little slider here to move to the position in the video where you want to add your annotation. All right, so now you want to click on Add Annotation. As you can see, there's several types of annotations here. You got speech bubble, note, title, spotlight, and label. I'm going to go into each one. Some of them I'm not going to tell you much about because they're just like some of the others. So let's start off with speech bubble. If you click on speech bubble, it'll add this little speech bubble to your video. You can left click and drag on it to move it where you want to. And you can also left click any of the grab points to position it and make it look how you want it to look. Also, there's a drag point that has the little piece that points to the person speaking. So you can drag that to where you want as well. So that is pointed towards the individual. Now to add text to it, you can just put your cursor here in this box, click on it, and then type in your text. You got several options for the actual speech bubble. You got custom, you got normal, and then you have another option on here called impact. So if you click on impact, it adds a shadow and a little bevel to the speech bubble. Now let's move on to the text. For the text, you got your font size, and you also have your font color. And then you have the background for your text bubble. You can change it to different colors, however you like. You also have your start time and your end time. The start time is the time that the annotation pops up on the screen and starts. The end time is the time that the annotation leaves the screen and it stops. So you can type in the times manually. Or you can go down here to this section and you'll see there's a little speech bubble. This is telling you that this is the annotation for the speech bubble. The red line on the left is when it comes in, it starts. The red line on the right is when it ends. You can actually left click and drag the start or the end piece of this to make the annotation last longer or shorter, however you want to do. And the last option on here is to add a link. If you click on link, you can add a link to several different things. You can add a link to your video, to a playlist you made of videos, to your YouTube channel, your Google Plus profile. You can add a link to get people to subscribe or actually have them subscribe to your channel. If you have a fundraising project with one of the multiple fundraising projects that YouTube is associated with, you can add a link to that fundraising project. If you have a website that you have linked to your YouTube channel, you can link to an associated website. And if you have a merchandise store that you have hooked up with YouTube, you can link to that merchandise store. So let's say we go ahead and link to a video. I'm going to paste this video link in here. Now you have an option to start the video at the beginning or a specific time of the video if you want to change that. And then you have the option to open a link in a new window. So if you want people to keep watching the video that they're watching and you want the new video to open up in a new window, then you click on this. You want to click on preview link to test to make sure that it's going to the right video and everything.
I know you like your stuff to be custom.
And it's working out just fine. And then when you're done, you can hit publish and it'll publish this link where it is. Now, if you want to add more, you don't have to hit publish yet. You can go ahead and hit add annotation. So the note annotation is just like the speech bubble, except for the fact that it doesn't have a little thing on it to point towards the person. So this is just good to use for words that you want to put somewhere like, I goofed up. It's 5, not 10 seconds. Something like that. Like if you made a mistake in a video, or let's say you just want to link to something, you just want to put the name or what you want to link to, notes are good for that. And another good thing about this is, let's say I got the notes. You can have as many annotations at the same place, overlapping, whatever. But let's say I was like, I want to put this somewhere else. Can move it forward to a different position just by left clicking it and dragging it over. Now you'll see that when I get to the other part in the video, that link is now there. Let's change this. Okay. All right. So that's a note. You also got title. So if you want to add a title to your video, this is a pretty good thing. I mean, you can't do any links or anything like that. It's just what it says. It's supposed to be a title. So we'll call this under construction. And then I can make this bigger so that I can show everything, and I'll just move it there. Boom. So now we got a nice little title. Another type of annotation that we got is spotlight. So spotlight is the one that most people use for things like making things clickable, like a clickable thumbnail, a clickable subscribe button, a clickable video that will lead you to another spot. Because what it does is, once it gets to it, it actually, you hover over it and you can't see it until you hover over it. So it makes it look more like it's just a regular button, and then it highlights it or spotlights it when you hover over it. So if I do add annotation and I select spotlight, just drag it where I want and use my grab points by left clicking on it, dragging it out to the same size. And now you see when I hover over it, it spotlights it. Now there is the ability to add text to this piece, but most people don't do that. I'm one of them that doesn't, because I just want them to click on the thing and I just make it say what I want it to say, like subscribe. You see this button says subscribe already, so I don't got to put text in there. So I could just go ahead and say, hey, link me to that other, my channel. So if I say subscribe for this one, all I need to do now is type in my YouTube URL. If you don't have a YouTube URL or a specific URL that you like, I got a video out there for it. Check it out. Shows you how to set up a custom YouTube URL that could be a name just like yours. And if I preview this link, you'll see that it takes you to my page where people could subscribe. All right, pretty simple, easy to do. Now, once again, I got a whole lot of things on here that I could do. Spotlights on, the subscribe button, all of these video thumbnails. I can add as many of the same spotlights for the same time period as I want on this page, and they will all be clickable and will take you to the videos, the subscribe page, or whatever I set up. Now, another good thing that I like about this here is you can actually set this up to take you to, let's say, a different part of the same video. The cool thing about that is, let's say I go to my page here. And I go back to my video manager. I select the same video. You want to select the same video because when you add a link, the link is going to be to the same video. So let's say at this point, I change this from subscribe to video. And I put the link for this exact same video in here. This time, I'm going to change the start linked video at, and I'll say 5 seconds. And I'm not going to have it open up in a new window because I want it to seem like I'm just rewinding back to 5 seconds in the video. So now if I click on this preview link, it's going to take me to the same video, but at the 5 second mark. And if I was watching this video, it wouldn't open up a new window. It would just take me back to the 5 second mark within the same window because I didn't choose to open it up in a new window. All right, last one we got on here is label. Labels just like a spotlight, except you could use it for something that doesn't have any words, like it doesn't say subscribe or it doesn't have the thumbnails with the pictures. Because what it does is, see, I drag this down here, it will add a little thing at the bottom. When you hover over it with the words that you put in it. So if you want to have some words showing underneath it, but you don't want to have it covering up what you're spotlighting, a label is a good way to do that. And then you can still add your links, start time, stop time, all that goodness. All right. Once you're done making all your annotations, all you got to do is hit publish. And then when you go back to watch a video, you will see all of the lovely annotations that you added. They will show up and be beautiful to your heart's content. There you go, people. Annotations all up in your face. All right, guys, you know the routine. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction. Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comment. You know I love comments. Leave me questions. I'll give you answers. All right? You need help? You're in the right place. Don't forget, subscribe. Click on the little button to the side. Get your sub on. Get your sub on. And if you need some more YouTube love, all you got to do is watch these videos. Watch these videos. You guys know what to do, so get to clicking.